I have a small activity for you in the beginning. So before we just start on the actual part of visual design, and for that I wanted to show you a particular instance. During this year's Miss Universe pageant, there was a major showdown which happened. I don't know how many of you are aware, but I'll give you the context of it. The announcer was supposed to say the winners in a order of 3, 2, and 1, like they have it in Oscars, and he actually did that to the best of his ability. But there was a goof up, and the goof up was that he announced number 3 and number 2, and then he didn't see anything else, so he thought that is number 1. So he said number 2 is number 1, which was I think Philippines. And the crown was given and everything happened, and later in a second he realized that he was mistaken. So he actually apologized and then said, here is a mistake, actually she is number 2 and number 1 is someone else. So then the crown was taken out and then given to the newly announced Miss Universe, which was really embarrassing for the organizers as well as everyone. However, most of the visual designers in the world attributed this kind of a blunder to the visual design of the card which was handed over to this announcer. And this is the card. So what I have done now is I have some copies of the card. Give it to you. You have a look at it. And on the back side, so this is activity which is called think, pair, share. So at the think level, you have to think individually what are the mistakes in that and try to circle them on your own card. First and foremost, write your roll number somewhere on the corner and then try to figure out what are the mistakes. After like 5 minutes, let us do a share where you compare your neighbor's comments with your comments. And the third step where we have share, that time use the back side of the card to redesign a card which you feel should have been better if this blunder was to be avoided. So got the activity? So let's do that. Just a suggestion, we are not supposed to comment on the text part. The text is something given. We cannot do that. The designer has no say on the text part. But what designer has a say is how to arrange the text, right? So try to see what you can make best out of this particular arrangement. So now probably you can, you can shift to him so that you have a pair. Try to see if you have a pair everywhere. So there are 3 in that third row. Hi. So one of you can come and join him here. Yeah, you are 3 of you. So one of you can come and join in here. He's, now there are perfect pairs. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, sit here. Huh? Now that will be a pair, right? Can you start sharing and share what you found out the problems in the sheet as opposed to what your partner found out? Okay, so whatever problem you have found, just circle it. And okay, anything what you found? You didn't get the point.
Yes.
Okay, so this is the card. Okay, can you explain him? Hey, do you have a microphone so that anyone who has missed out, you don't have a microphone here. Okay, fine. Are there some similarities in what you found and what your partner found, or are they quite different? Different or same? Okay, so how many people, by the way, let's do that at the share level. Oh, you're creating the design now?
Yeah.
Okay, the third part, okay. Anything?
Miss Universe can be at the top. Its font size is good. Then the first runner-up and then the second runner-up.
Okay, so you want it not the Oscars way. You wanted like winner, first runner-up, second runner-up. Okay, maybe that they wanted the suspense to be built up.
The sequence should be first Miss Universe 2015 that we on the top, Then second one is first runner up, Colombia. I think Colombia has been mentioned and little bit on top side. It should be on the center of the line. Okay. Here. And third one is second runner up.
Yeah, more or less same, sir. Actually, it's about like country should be, it should be down actually instead of up.
Should be down.
Philippines, like how they are written in the Miss Universe 2015. Philippines,
okay.
In the down.
Okay, so they mean that the title should be on the top, followed by the country.
Yes.
Right. And any other observation?
Same as that.
Same.
How many people feel the same? Okay, you feel the reverse. Okay, why?
Is it fine? The order I feel is fine because in such big competitions, you always get the try to maintain the suspense, right? So all I wanted to say that if they should be justified, because as we said, as we saw that Steve Harvey was right-handed, so he probably would have holded it like this,
yes.
Held it like this, and he could have seen only USA and Colombia and forgot. This is totally can be seen as the heading of the show, that is the final. He might have missed it like this.
Okay.
So if the other was left-handed, he would have stored it like this.
So his analogy was that he holds the card like this. Then he doesn't see Philippines at all. So he just sees, okay, this is Miss Universe 2015 show going on. And he reads rest of the thing on the card. Only when he holds it like this, he realizes he made a mistake.
I would say that all the three should be justified in the center. So it doesn't matter if you are left-handed or right-handed.
Okay. So whether he is a left-handed or a right-handed doesn't matter. And for people like me who will hold it in the center, probably you don't know. Okay. By the way, remember, this is normally people talk about user-centric design and keeping user in mind while you design. By the way, the context of this particular design was worldwide show of a stretcher, and the person who was the user was a very, very trained and renowned illiterate man or something. It's not that he had never done this kind of a show. So all such things were taken into consideration. Probably he will know that the card has to be held in this manner or something. All that must have been thought of by designers. Still this thing happened. And so now actually based on these suggestions, use the back side of this thing and actually draw whatever you thought of. And then I'll show you what designers worldwide have also tried. Probably it can match what you are saying already. Let's see. You need another page? You add some text? Probably, okay, you try that. That's also fine. Okay, so he wants to add some more text because he feels that this is not adequate to communicate. Okay. Yeah, done. Can you show that from there? I have two entries, almost identical. Anyone who has not done this? Achha, they have written elimination in the text itself, right? But it's a result card. That's what you wanted. Okay. Probably they want to say that the other two are eliminated and now the one which is remaining is Miss Universe. So not that only a round after round there are eliminations, even the finals are an elimination in a way, because you get only one winner. So others are eliminated automatically. Okay. We have a couple of them. We have a table actually, someone has submitted. So that it is pretty clear that you read by rows and don't get confused about. I have similar looking, this is slightly different. What's different here? You have a patch for the winner to distinguish from the rest. Yeah, please come. But most of them are otherwise same. What interestingly, what everyone has tried to do is put a line across from the name to the text, right? So that there is no confusion about arrangement. This is Miss Universe is on the top, then first runner up and second runner up, right? And this is a bit messy, but let us see what other designers had to say. So first of all, what you see here is a TV grab of what was handed over to Steve. Steve was the anchor that day. Yeah. One thing which I can immediately comment on is most of you have used only the upper portion of the card, leaving half of it blank, which is not a very good idea, especially when you have this much of a size of a card. They make sure that the font size is so big that even in the dimmest light possible, because they may dim the light at the time of final announcement and all that, so visibility becomes an issue. So all this 14 point Helvetica will be a nightmare for people to read. Anyway, so this was what he had got, and I have actually created a dummy out of what I saw on TV. Okay, so you have a different font size here, but let us see what people had done. Okay, so this was by someone called Marco, and what is the difference? Actually, you can see the color is already gone. So try to use gray for the first and second runner up, and the winner was black and bold and all that, right? And like you said, he has added the word winner there, so it's clear. There's no confusion about it. Okay, here is one more by Sai. Sai did a gradation of gray, like light gray, dark gray, and black, so that it is ascending order is clear. And Miss Universe has a special color. This was like the one with just the text, what you have submitted, most of you, the one in between, not this one, but the one here. So you say the second runner up write something, and they have written instruction: read second runner up, first runner up, and winner. So in case you are confused, just follow the instructions. So something like that. This was one of them where countries are written in bold so that they can read out loud. There was one more where they gave a special treatment for Miss Universe, and I'll tell you that normally they are not printed on one single piece of card. They print on papers, cut those papers, the strips of the names of the countries, and they are pasted in front of them. That is why most of you have commented on the old design, that there is too much gap between the line which is there and the text which is up there. It is because they have actually cut this word USA from a piece of paper and pasted it there. Because that happens live. So it's not a pre-printed card 2 days back that they can create and just show it there. Probably they are, but they are not fixed this much. But they have to at least pretend that they are not fixed, and they do it like that. So this is why they have to keep space for the paper to be pasted inside. Okay. So somebody has done this. In fact, he commented that why these cards, whenever they are used in these kind of shows, are black and white on one side. They, you have color on the other side. Typically, you see all these reality show cards, they'll have the logo and everything printed on this side so that the audience can see. But the reader has only black and white print on the other side. So why so? He said, why not have Miss Universe printed in color and all that? So there was some logic there. This was interesting. He actually printed an arrow. Okay, read right first, then go down. So though no confusions here how to read it. So start from left, go right, then come down. I tried making one myself by adding numbers, just in case this will help. So I saw everything, and then I decided to design one for myself. And I said, okay, 3 is Miss USA and 2 is, because this jargon I was finding very confusing, second runner-up and first runner-up. So instead of that, I thought just 3-2-1 is fine. In fact, someone gave a suggestion that why not use the athletics podium, saying that, okay, this is third, this is second, and this is first. So it's very clear who is what. The point was that when we have such kind of problems in order to design something or communicate visually, let's call it like that, then we see that there are so many different aspects of that. And what I'm going to do now is to discuss some of them so that we can understand the visual communication skill part in this course of communication skills. Okay, so what I am going to talk about in the next two sessions, which are more than 75 minutes or something, right? 90 minutes late. Okay. So these are two people who have inspired me to bring up this lecture in the way it is. So there are various aspects of visual communication which determine the communication. So, and people ask me this question quite common, that what are the components which should be taken care of? Is it font? Is it color? Is it what is that? So there is no pinpointed answer to that. Yes, if you fix fonts, then you are fine. It's not like that. It's a combination of things, and that's how it creates the communication, what you want to say. So I am going to cover a range of things, but I am going to also talk about how you can facilitate better visual communication if you follow a certain process of planning first and then executing it, rather than executing it and then reworking on the plan part, which happens in most of the cases. Have you seen this case study, by the way? This was submitted by one, I think, 14-year-old Indian boy to the US government, saying that if you change your official font from Times Roman to something called Garamond, you will save like $400 million a year, because whatever printing you do, government printing, whatever is done, the ink used would be less. So he calculated the mathematics for that and then came up with this theory. Obviously, it was trashed immediately, because, and you can see the reason why could that be not acceptable. You see the difference in two fonts. What's the difference? Readability is compromised, right? You print to read. So if even if whatever amount of ink you save is not going to help if it is not readable at all. So just changing the font, is the font is being chosen after a lot of thought behind it, and readability was never compromised. The first attribute or the function of printing is to make it readable. If that is not happening, then there is no point in saving ink and printing something which is not readable. Similarly, what is there in design? So excellent data, completely correct data, very valid experiment, you have got some beautiful results. But when it is shown, nobody understands anything, because the way it is presented, it's pretty confusing. There is no alignment to the chunks which are shown there, and becomes a chaos. Similarly, color, whatever text you have written on that, however good it is, completely useless because of the choice of colors, choice of images, some choice of forms in that. In fact, the theory of whether you should use white background and black text or black background and white text also plays a very important role, which I will cover later on. So therefore, what I wanted to stress upon is we have to start the plan phase directly getting into the impress phase of any presentation. And this is, I am saying, after looking at so many examples, that whenever a presentation is being created, the first thing a lot of people do is go to the presentation tool, whatever is being chosen, search for templates, whatever are available, and then spend a lot of time in the front slide, whatever creativity can be put in there, and what graphics and what font and all that. And then just start slide by slide. And then you realize, oh, this is not covering something, so add a slide and keep adding slide. Then you have, suppose you have marked it, like referencing is done internally, that will also go for a toss because you have kept adding slides here and there. So you will finally end up with a lot of mess, and you have to keep on shuffling between the slides at the end. See, instead of that, if it is done in a way that you plan first, then you execute that plan using some tool, and finally at the time of impress, you improvise on how well you can communicate. That verbal thing comes in this thing. By the way, I'm restricting visual communication right now to presentations. So we can apply some of these to documents also, but right now I'm talking about presentations. So the technique I, as an example, I'm going to use in this particular class is going to be about brainstorming and for the planning phase. So we are going to use a technique for brainstorming, and that is called creating affinity maps. So we are going to do that activity after some time. Then from that brainstorming, we can analyze whatever we have brainstormed, whatever content has come up, then organize it in a way that is useful for us. and then go to the outline part of presentation where that can be converted to a presentation. So that is execute level is where you actually touch the computer. Till then you have not touched the computer. And finally, when you have the impress part, you look into what should be the color scheme, what should be the typography, what kind of fonts to be used, and color and transitions and all sorts of things can be applied at that point. And finally, practice before you present. So this is that is why it is written in all caps and everything, which I have seen most of them doing just like 5 minutes before, just browsing through the slides hurriedly what is the seminar is going to happen. So that is something which has to be avoided all the time. If you can just practice earlier on, it just shows off when you present it. Okay, we are going to focus on the plan stage in today's session, and the reason why I'm stressing on this is because most of the people try the other way around. They start with impress. They okay, start with color scheme, font, and all that, and then come to execute. And the example is of the legendary filmmaker. So I come from fine arts and filmmaking background. So most of my examples may come from that domain. So you have to excuse me for that. But I thought they were relevant. So Satyajit Ray had this ability to note down each and every detail about the film he was making in the form of text and everything, whatever he could. And he was an excellent artist himself, so he could draw and note down everything. So the character was etched out on the paper itself before even the shooting used to start. And when the shooting started, so that is the plan phase, he spent a lot of time on that detailing. When it came to execute stage, where the film was being shot, he used to be there to monitor each and every minute detail, whether the beard is correct or not according to his requirement. And he will go there, and he can do the makeup part also because he was an artist. He will go there and do the makeup himself if he is not satisfied. And finally, you get some world class things like those are endorsed by even the Academy of the world. So this is how people do that. And if we want to plan the presentations, it's not that it will be always okay. So like I said already, there will be some images which will be directly coming from the entertainment domain. What we have analyzed, this was actually one of the presentation slide from Microsoft Research Summer School at Bangalore, and Professor Kentaro, who was the then head of Microsoft Research, presented this interesting analogy to all of us. And what he said was, typical talk is a story of a film. And how? So let's see. So what's the story of a film? Typically, it starts with boy meeting a girl, and girl is ignoring, so boy tries to probe further, and boy plots some plan to get the girl. The plot will work, and then happiness ever after is a typical story. Let's try to distill this information further and see what we get. So what is this? This is actually a setup. You introduce characters, you set it up properly, you know where is it happening and all that. Then you start the conflict part, that it's not working and all that. And there is a plot, which is a kind of a false climax, because the boy will get the first jitter. And then there is some action because the boy has a plot which will work, and then there is a climax and all that, right? So if we try to translate this in a real life problem, like a typical seminar report or a paper for that matter, so this is how it will probably look like. You'll have introduction, you'll have some problem and observation, you'll have related work which will lead you to propose solution, you'll analyze it, and the results will show that they work, and therefore you can talk about future work and what is the discussion about, and then go ahead. And why? But
why is there a second
false climax?
Why is the second one also a false climax?
So climax is a term where it is used that it takes you to the point of the clash. So it can be both ways. So even if it does, so it is called climax, and so this can be a climax actually. And but I wanted to have this as a finale, so I just tried to show that. So in short, what happens is a typical talk outline can make into a good story, and people really love stories. People will never hate whatever you are telling. But if it has been woven in that format, only then it will be. And most of the stories or the presentations fail because they don't have this storyline going in the background. They start arbitrarily, and related work will get into introduction, and results will get into discussion, and all sorts of things will happen, where they don't, the users or the people who are attending fail to understand where are we right now, in the, what phase of the story are we right now. So they get confused about characters, variables, and all the forces which are there in that story, and that's when the presentations tend to fail most of the time. So let us get back to the plan stage, what we were planning to do. And okay, so we have these 6 topics randomly I have selected from whatever I could see around. Most of them I have tried with the CSE counterparts of the same course, so I know that they work. Now let us split ourselves into at least 4 groups, probably if not 6 groups, there will be like 2 small groups. How many people? 20, 22 thing, right? So let's have like a group of 4 for each topic, right? And just we keep on going. So the first, movement and navigation, these 4 people, and we are just going to go ahead. So you guys can pair up with either them or them, and you can also pair up with them. So they are sitting quite nearer, so you can just shift here, and this can be the second group, that can be the 4th group, that can be the 5th group, and there is a 6th group. So you can have 3 group of 3 probably. So then there are equal number, then now 4 and 2. Okay. So this is group number 1. So just what I now need to do is to give you these sheets. By the way, it's going to be a lot of activity in this particular session. Okay, so you can pass on to the groups behind. So it's 1 per group. So you can say write the group name on that sheet. So that will be about movement and navigation, the first one. You guys write about movement and navigation. Write as big as possible so that we can see it. And food quality and internet and connectivity, okay. And building and other infrastructure, energy audit, this group, and waste management is the 6th group. Okay, so everyone has the group names now. What? Okay, this was for the CSE part. Okay, so now we are at the ideation stage, and I am going to pull out another paper for all of you. What you have to do now is I'll give you some post-it stickers. Whatever ideas come to your mind. By the way, I'll again go back to this thing because this mistake was done by CSE guys. Okay, these topics are with reference to IIT campus only. So don't go out and global waste management problem and all that is not expected in this class. We are only talking about IIT Bombay. So that is why the group of 4 will help, because if someone is a real fresher on the campus, probably the others can help. One. Second is, there could be the topic inherently may talk about problems as such. In sense, the first thing which hits you when you see internet network, so immediately you hit, okay, problems with internet and connectivity on campus. So it need not be only about problems. It can also be about facilities available versus facilities not available, or quality of facility available versus non-available, anything. The point is that you have to just start jotting down whatever comes to your mind in these particular topics what you have, and start putting it on. So just pass it on to some of your members, and they should start writing on these papers and keep pasting them on the sheets.
In what direction do we have to think? I mean, what should we write?
Okay, what should we write? So the point is that at the end of these sessions, we have to have a presentation on one of these topics by the group. So you can talk about the pros and cons both. You can talk about additional things which could be done, which are not present, anything. But you have to actually try to see if you can cumulatively come up with a presentation on this, maybe of 6 slides, not more than that. like we have those six bullets, introduction and all that. Similar problem, probably you can take the theme for the presentation, but you have to brainstorm for whatever ideas you can come up with. And the rule for brainstorming is that don't be judgmental at this point, and just distribute among four of you, and you can typically try to keep it single color for a group. So all you have to do is whatever topic comes to your mind, write on the post-it and put it up on that big paper. Right now, don't worry about arrangement part. It can be pasted anywhere. We'll do that arrangement as second stage, where I will tell you to think about whether there is connectivity between these two topics or not. But right now, whatever comes to your mind, just keep it on that. Yeah, that these are the only two guidelines. Don't be judgmental. Keep writing on the note. So you have, what is the topic of this?
Movement.
So write that first of all. Somewhere you write that big size. What is the topic? Okay, so movement and navigation. So they have couple of topics here. What is this about?
Food quality.
Okay. Menu and wastage tracking, kitchen maintenance, hygiene, no plastic cups. Okay, so what I'm going to do is now I'm going to later on share this with other group. Your chart will be given to other group. So they will add some more sticky on that if they can think of. Okay, anything? Energy audit and usage. Sources, analysis, methods, conduct energy summit, awareness, project. Okay, this still sounds like as a global problem. What will be more relevant to IIT Bombay campus as such?
This is
about it. Okay, have energy summit every year. I'm saying this is amount of usage on campus.
Yeah.
Okay, and analysis of energy wastage on campus.
Yeah.
Okay, and fine. So go deeper than try to slightly objective. Okay.
Actually, waste management.
Waste management.
There
okay.
Are many ways of waste.
So canteen waste, plastic waste, biodegradable waste, water management. Okay.
How we are converting this one into the.
Then we have bio production, recycling,
methane production.
Okay. So are they rows or columns and rows? Okay. You have already started columns and rows.
Yes.
These guys seem to be most easy chilled out condition because they have put it at least on random say. Building and other infrastructure. So better equipment and classroom, good transportation road. So separate laboratory for each field. Okay. Availability of SAC, library, okay, this is great. In fact, just to tell you interesting anecdote, when this topic was given to one of the groups in CSE, they were somewhere in the middle, could all the groups but not that group. And when they just forwarded to each other and they realized this group had listed out all the buildings on the campus. As the title said, building and infrastructure, okay, here are the buildings and infrastructure. Victor Menendez in Crescent, department of CSE, department of that. And I said, this was a bit too much. Anyway, okay, so you guys can go for one step deeper than what you have written right now. So you have written about this. I think the goodies to be given out in this class should be post-it stickers. Probably a lot of people are aspiring for getting it. Okay. The organizing part of what you have just thrown out on paper. So one of the technique is called chunking. So what it does is that it allows you to group the content, which is just randomly spread all over the place, in a cohesive manner so that you can make buckets where you can put all the content there. So just to show an example, if I tell you to remember these number of alphabets and tell me after some time, what are the techniques that you can apply to do that? Again, this is a think, pair, share activity. So if I tell you to tell me these alphabets, which are just randomly put up there, so what technique can be used?
Like,
okay, so like so associate the occurrence of the alphabet according to the number, so 1 to 26, and say that it is, so G becomes 7 or whatever, then 7 and 13 and all that, okay. So comma separated values, and then you read. Okay, vowels and consonants can be separated, and you can also count the numbers. Say okay, 3 E's and 2 I's and all that. Okay, anything else? If I
learning the same sequence. So.
Okay, this is a great question. So am I expecting sequence again, or I can be okay with any sequence? I am okay with any sequence. Okay, what is the probability of getting the correct answer in any one of these methods? With the comma separated values, probably it is quite high even in this, but you have to basically struggle to keep picture of this. Okay. So make pictograms like G for goat and then N for nuclear bomb, and so you just remember the pictures in a row, probably you will end up with a big story. Yeah, I actually just said that in reaction to that, but you picked up properly. So make smaller words and try to remember them, because now I have lifted this regulation that I don't want the correct order. You can put it in any order. So there could be various techniques, and I wanted to do that as ThinkPair. In a big classroom, we do it as a ThinkPair activity again, but now that it's a small class, we can just do a loud thinking option. Okay. So there could be various ways, right? So you can have that numbers, but it may not be very interesting to remember them, and you have to basically do a lot of homework to create those comma separated values and all that. But how about creating the small words? And there will be some very arbitrary words. There could be some camel, and then there is no reference to what we are trying to say. Okay, there could be Iceman, hens, lingering, and all that. But what if we make mechanical engineering out of it? It's more easy to remember, right? So you can't remember Iceman, hens, lingering, or camel, enriching engine, mini cancer. It's very difficult because they are out of context for you. But if I say make mechanical engineering out of these alphabets, you will never forget those alphabets. You tell me anytime, you will just write down and say these are the alphabets you asked for. It happens that only with context you can remember things very nicely. So if you put context, then the recall value and the retention value of any content you give is very high, and that is missing sometimes in the presentations, what I see, because they are completely into the context, but they fail to communicate that context to the person who is listening to them. So they start off, whether because they are immersed in that seminar for last 2 months probably, or at least 2 nights before that, and then they come up and suddenly stand in front of and start speaking. The person listening to you may not be in that context. A person may be attending already 4 seminars before you of completely different subjects. So it takes time for that person to assimilate, and by the time you have gone much deeper into your context. So it's important to have that context part before you actually think else. So let us try now, make, instead of making these kind of out of whatever you have on the paper, try making this kind of words, which will make you easily understandable, so that you can recall them anytime. Now try to pick up those post-its and put it up on different position by titling them into a group, and then segregate them into different parts of the presentation. So try to do that now with all the post-its what you have. Try to pick them up and put them into a different order now, so which will be more cohesive for you to present. So try to do that with whatever post-its you have, and see if you have to debate about whether the position of this post-it is valid at this point, or it can be put up into something else. If you find that there is a topic which is relevant in two things, just copy that post-it and keep it in both. That's also valid. So that is how now we have to do. We will not do this part because you have already done it in the class here, the affinity diagram what you have created. But what we will do now is to convert this, or to capture this in a different mode called a mind map. So what basically you are creating, like most of them are creating a row and column type of a thing, which is good, but it just gives that hint of hierarchy every time. So topmost is the most important problem and followed by or something. So if you come up with a bigger problem later on, then you still have a chance to replace the post-it, but that is not the idea to have those hierarchical things. Right now it is everything at a flat level, so there is no hierarchy right now. That's why I mentioned to a couple of groups that you can just draw some big blobs around and try to show them. But one of the representation is like this, which is called mind maps. By the way, this technique is very commonly used nowadays in order to capture content. Most of the students nowadays practice mind maps, even to take notes. So you are in a class and you want to say, instead of writing linear things, you just keep drawing those blobs and try to do that. One interesting thing which I personally I use is this thing, which is a combination of something mind map plus a concept map. And why is that? So because technically these two are different, but when you label the connections, that is one of the best feature of concept map. So mind map doesn't have actually these labels for the connections. I personally use that a lot. That's why I like this type of a mind map, having the but mind maps also allows me to go beyond these standard squares and triangles, and it allows me to draw arbitrary shapes. So being an artist, I enjoy that better than anything else. So what we will now do is try to create those post-its over a period of time till the next lecture actually, and you have an entire mid-sem week in between. So the lecture after this, I think it is 22nd of March. So before that, I think we will put up on Moodle a link to upload. But what you have to do is you have to create a mind map or a concept map from this post-it thing. So before you move, probably you want to take a picture of that, and one of you should store it with you. You can take the map also, but ideally, first of all, before it gets deleted or whatever, post it on Moodle. So I'll put up a link now, and on that you can just post it first of all as a group. So there will be only 6 entries, by the way. It's not an individual entry. You have to give one per group, and you can just label it as the name of the group. So you can say wastemanagement.jpg, whatever, so that it is having no confusion. And what you have to do is use any one of these free mind mapping tools to create the mind map of this affinity diagram what you have created, and upload it. So before 29th of February, you should do that. So I'll get a chance to analyze them on 1st, and we'll meet on 2nd, when we will discuss some of them, and then we will go further to the next phase of execute and impress part. So that will be the plan for next session. Is there any question? We still have 4 minutes to discuss.
So you were saying like we should include the context before starting presenting something. So the terms in that context will be, most of the people won't be knowing that terms, so they may start questioning from
right
that
there.
Point on.
Okay. So did you all get the question what he got, he was asking? So when you say establish the context before you explain, so the questions might start right then and before I explain the entire thing. And he is actually coming from a very particular standpoint of seminar presentation, because when you start a seminar and if you start spending time on the context and the reviewer starts saying, "Oh, sab theek hai, tum pehle batao, tumne kaam kya kiya hai," types. So what to do in such a situation? Is that right? Okay. Because this was a common question in even CSE when we discussed this. So chunking and brainstorming helps a lot in this phase especially, because establishing context doesn't mean that you have to spend a lot of time on the introduction part itself. You have to be very sharp in presenting what you are doing. At the same time, you shouldn't lose out any connection which is important but not covered. So that takes lot of time, and typically if you don't go by the plan phase thoroughly, then you end up with 4 slides on introduction itself, which nobody wants to see, because when the reviewers start looking at presentation, ek slide ho gaya, do slide ho gaya, intro chal raha hai, intro continued, so then they get jittery and they start asking, "Are bhai, theek hai, kaam kab dikhayega?" To ho gaya na, tera 10 minutes to isi mein gaya. We feel that we have to tell everything because the context is important for us. But how sharp we get into that point is very important, and some very interesting techniques can be done for that. For example, if we introduce a term, we can explain it there, but hyperlink it with some paper or a reference or something and keep it there available for us. If a question pops up on that, link is already there, click on that and go to that and explain if required. But most of the time, we spend another slide on explaining that term and all that. So then we have to talk about it for next 3-4 minutes. Then we have another term and we keep on doing that till we finish all our terms which are to be used in that particular seminar or presentation. And that actually bugs the reviewers who are listening to you on that. So this is one of the techniques, but we will come back on this because this is a very, very important and pertaining issue which has to be addressed and how to deal with that. I will try to post some things on Moodle also for this, and we will discuss this in the next class. This is a good point. One of the ways is to do the brainstorm part well, because that gives you a chance to filter out what is important, what comes out earlier, and then what has to be eliminated also from that. So it doesn't mean that everything what is present has to be presented in the initial slides on introduction. It's not that case. And that is, I think, one of the mistakes done most of the times. Anything else? Or we can just call it today for now. Thank you very much. I'll see you on second.